Professor John Daniels and his students in the William States Lee College of Engineering, in conjunction with Idea Center Senior Fellow Christopher Hardin, have been researching the leachability of fly ash, a byproduct generated by coal-fired power plants. This research is helping the EPA validate testing methods, and it's helping the power industry find sustainable ways to store and reuse coal ash.
My research on coal fly ash focuses on characterizing the material so that we can reuse it in a variety of applications. You know, coal's been around for a long time, and currently coal accounts for nearly 50% of our electricity. In this country, we produce a little over 100 million metric tons of ash every year, and this includes all types of ash. A lot of this material is produced, and so the question is, well, what do we do with this material? Air pollution requirements have changed. So we now have much more stringent regulations for sulfur dioxide, nitrous oxides, and other materials that are released from the combustion of coal. And because of that, the way coal was burned and the way the downstream gases are processed, that changes the quality and character of ash. Secondly, and this is the largest issue perhaps as to why this has become a big issue, is catastrophic failure at the Tennessee Valley Authority, where a little over 5 million cubic yards of coal fly ash were released from a dike. And because of that, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, which for years has been advocating for the reuse of coal fly ash, began to solicit opinion as to whether coal fly ash should be regulated in a different manner. One of the things that's being done is reevaluating how we test ash for that which is sometimes the principal concern, leachability. Coal comes from the earth. And you know, when you mine coal and you burn coal, you release trace metals that are also part of the parent geology. So coal fly ash, much like soil, has trace levels of various metals and other constituents, things like arsenic and chromium and selenium, things which we don't want at elevated concentrations in our groundwater. As part of this process of developing a new leaching protocol, my lab is doing some of this testing. And one of the reasons our lab is doing this testing is because we've been involved in leachate testing for years.
I'm doing research on reducing the leachability of coal fly ash, and we're using the new test, leachability test developed by Vanderbilt University. Method 1313 involves subjecting the ash to different pH levels. So we take 20 grams of ash, put it in a 250 milliliter bottle, and add 200 milliliters of liquid. We add base or acid to reach the specific pH levels that they want for each test position. And then when we get done, we can chart what comes out of the leachate based on what the pH level that extracted it.
One of the unique things about UNC Charlotte is our orientation to collaboration in general, and with industry in particular. So if you think about the mission of a university, it's several fold. Of course, there's education, and then there's research and service. On the research side of things, research occurs at many different levels. And so a lot of times we partner with industry to find solutions to problems which exist right now. Now, some of these solutions do in fact require longer term research endeavors. But one of the unique things about our university, and that you see this play out through our Ideas Center and our EPIC Center, both of them partner extensively with consultants, with industry, with folks at utilities, with all sectors you can imagine, because when you're trying to solve problems, you need the perspective of multiple disciplines, and you also need the perspective of folks in different sectors.
I'm working with Dr. Daniels on just a lot of fly ash type research, and mainly in the areas of leachability and stability for fly ash. I designed one of the first landfills after the Kinston failure, and it was on top of a wet coal ash basin, actually a dry coal ash basin. So I was looking for someone who could provide me additional information on strength parameters, leachability concerns. And as I came to UNC Charlotte and got connected with Dr. John Daniels here, they really have a very strong bench. They've got, I think, 6 or 7 professionals directly involved in doing coal ash, coal combustion ash research. They've also got great lab facilities. The best thing about UNC Charlotte, I say this a lot, is it's a safe place to think innovative thoughts. You can think outside the box, but it's also a place to get those thoughts grounded with good research and practical application.
Coal, if you look at its usage, is forecasted to, right now, it's approximately 50% of our electricity is derived from coal. That's not expected to change significantly throughout my lifetime. Over the next 30 years, we're still expected to burn nearly as much coal as we are today to satisfy our energy demands. And so, but naturally, we need to pursue all forms of energy. Ideally, renewables will take on a greater fraction of our energy mix. But it's important to understand, even if we stopped burning coal today, which by all measure doesn't look like that's going to happen, but even if we stopped burning coal today, because of the amount of ash that is generated, we would still have several billion metric tons of coal fly ash and other coal products distributed throughout the country. And so it's important to understand, how is that material behaving? Where can we reuse it? How can we best make use of this material in a way that is sustainable and at the same time meeting real technical challenges?